I have a very funny name. Bucks is my name. People ask me why my name is Bucks. Well, I'm a love Bucks, you see. I spread love. I'm not a computer Bucks, so you don't have to worry about me. I have this name called Bucks because it was given to me when I was a small boy in school. So I have this character almost like Bugs Bunny, you know, very witty. So then I got stuck with the name Bucks. Then when I go to work, so I try to use my Chinese name, Tan Yao Kiang. But most of the people, they forget me. And then when they know my name is Bucks, they keep calling me Bucks, you know? They keep calling me Bucks. So that name then sounds good. And then now I realize that it actually brings a lot of benefit to me. I'm now a love Bucks, so to speak. I spread love, you know? So that way is good. I'm an inventor for a long time. And now I have moved on to become an innovation advisor, helping other people to put their product in the market, as well as reaching out to young children and teaching them the ropes of innovation and creativity. I also have won an award for one of the inventions that I invented for the oil platform. It's called Light Walk Grating. And this product, I have actually sold some to Petronas, one of the oil fields called Sumandang. In fact, this Light Walk Grating, I won 4 awards, you know. So I focus on where my strength is. My strength is on the creativity and in the innovation part. How to make. So I have to listen very clearly. What is the problem statement? What is the problem statement that a user encounter or a company encounter? So you tell me your problem statement. Once I understood your problem statement, you understand your problem, I would think technically how to solve that. So that's where I focus on. Not all invention require heavy science. Even simple idea like that, we can actually make money. My personal ambition is to, if I can educate the young one, as young as possible, 5, 7 years old, or 17 years old, or 27 years old, if I can tell them, look, you know, about innovation, what innovation can bring for you, you know, what can he bring for the country. So with that, when they grow up and when they go into an industry, then they can accept innovation. So it's going to be the next generation thing. Well, if you are still in school and you are about to be graduate from school, I'd like to give you some advice to tell you that having one big certificate that you're going to get at the end of the day, that is just a tool, you know, that is not good enough. That's not good enough. So you have to be a lot more hardworking to be good in your field. Then, when you go out to work, whether you're working for somebody or working for yourself, you are better than your other people. So you must always be on top of the situation that you are in. So having that big certificate that you're going to get is not good enough. So you have to innovate. You have to be curious. You have to create something. And you must understand, you know, this is a very competitive world. So if you do not know what you're doing, well, you are going to be the pack. You cannot be the leader. So keluarkan idea yang anda ada dan cubalah, you know, cuba komersialiskan dan cuba pakai atau cuba bangunkan itu untuk apa? This business business anda dan majukan sendiri dan untuk negara.
I was born in Kampa Perak back in 1965. Primary school and secondary school in Kampa Perak. Extend my education to study in the United States. First in University of Texas for my undergraduate in mechanical engineering. And then after that, did my graduate study at MIT in Boston. After I finished my graduate study, I found a job in Perlis, Malaysia. Initially worked as a process engineer. When I first started as a young engineer, I have some readings, and one of the readings of a book that attracted me the most is a book by Matsushita, the founders of Panasonic and National. and he promote this concept of peace, happiness and prosperity. Well, Just Read started back in 1995, and I asked myself, what does people need the internet the most for? And at that time, there are a lot of Malaysian students who are studying overseas, and it comes to my mind that a lot of these Malaysians need to find a job after they finish their school, and they do not have access to the newspaper at that time because they are studying overseas. So by putting the jobs on the internet, Malaysian students who are studying in England, Australia, United States and elsewhere, be able to see the jobs in Malaysia, apply for the jobs, and hopefully they'll be able to find a job even before they return back to Malaysia. This is one of our latest innovation in terms of the smartphone. It's an iPhone apps where we actually helps the job seekers to find jobs that is closest to where they are. So what you need to do is that it works on the iPad and it works the same on the iPhone. Shake the phone, it will detect where you are currently is, and then after that, it would find all the jobs that is next to you over here. Invention is something that is very big. You invent and people see, wow, it's changed the world. But there are a lot of small and small innovation, just a small improvement, and if you put a lot of those put in place, it actually changed the quality of life and improvement in the world. So I like to tell to all the graduates, we are not the world not looking for big invention. We are looking at small incremental innovation that happen every day. Selagi kita memang berhasrat untuk berinovasi, kita akan berjaya di Malaysia.
Okay, latar belakang saya, saya dilahirkan di Muar Johor. Saya dibesarkan di Melaka. Saya bersekolah di bandar, di Sekolah Kebangsaan Bandar Hilir. Kemudian saya di Sekolah Menengah Tinggi Melaka. Kemudian saya pindah ke Sekolah Kebangsaan Pandan Indah. Dan dari situ, sebab saya tengok saya memang minat bahagian grafik dengan multimedia, bahagian web ni. So saya tengok yang ada kursus yang melibatkan bahagian multimedia ni ialah di Multimedia Universiti sendiri lah di Tabajaya. Saya nak pergi ke bahagian animasi, sebab saya tengok animasi pada tu benda yang baru. Lagipun dia dalam bentuk 3D, saya nak belajar sendiri pun agak susah sebenarnya. Saya tengok, okay, ini benda-benda yang baru. So saya masuk ke dalam bidang tu. Daripada situ, saya berjumpa dengan kawan-kawan saya. So kita orang buat animasi lah, dia panggil Misi Mustahak. Jadi di Misi Mustahak ni, kalau tengok ada kat YouTube, memang adalah sambutannya. Dah berpuluh-puluh ribu juga orang melihat di YouTube. Dari situ kita tengok kita dapat semangat lah. Sebenarnya kita nak buat macam nak buat filem pula di peringkat kata national lah. So kita orang dapat rezeki, kita orang set up Leskopak Production masa tu dengan salah seorang daripada investor. Jadi bermula pada situ, kita buatlah geng pembaraan bermula. Jadi dalam geng ni, kita tengok ada banyak watak lah. Ada watak Badul, ada watak Lim, dan ada watak sampingan Upin dan Ipin. Jadi watak sampingan Upin dan Ipin ni, kita ketengahkan dia menjadi mini series, sebab kita nak test market pada masa tu. Nak test market, nak tengok macam ni penerimaan orang tentang kita punya penceritaan. Jadi pada 2009, saya berhenti daripada Leskopak Production. Saya buka studio saya sendiri, yang Mustah Studios. Dan kami sekarang ni tengah buat Bawa Boy lah. Bawa Boy ni, pada masa awal peringkat tu, kami banyak membuat research. Research ni maksudnya, kita tengok apa yang tak ada lagi di Malaysia dan apa lagi yang diperlukan oleh Malaysia dan juga di peringkat global, untuk mencari satu idea yang sangat related kepada rakyat Malaysia dan pada masa yang sama, unik di mata dunia, adalah satu benda yang susah. Tapi, jadi kita ambil masa yang lama lah, dari kurang 6 hingga 8 bulan untuk mencari idea ni. Tapi nama dia apa, kita tak dapat lagi. So kita buat lagi research. Jadi kita tanyalah orang Melayu, kalau panggil anak lelaki dia apa? Boy ataupun boy. Kita tanya orang Cina, dia panggil anak dia boy ataupun boy. Kita tanya orang India pun, dia panggil anak dia boy ataupun boy. So kita tengok di situ ada satu persamaan. Pada peringkat awal agak sukar untuk orang menyebut, sebab dia boy. Dia ada I dengan Y tu, dia susah sikit nak sebut. Tapi apa yang kita buat ialah kita cipta lagu untuk mengajar orang macam mana nak menyebutnya. Boy di Filipina nombor satu. Di Singapura nombor 2. Jadi di Malaysia nombor 1 kan. Jadi lepas ni kita pergi ke, hopefully dapat ke pergi Indonesia. Tapi benda ni saya tengok tak boleh stop di sini. Kita nak buat sesuatu, cerita kita, wajah kita sampai ke peringkat global. Tahun lepas saya dianugerahkan tokoh negara. Itu satu penghargaan lah daripada pihak kerajaan. Kita buat dari masing, yes, sesuatu yang menyeronokkan. Tapi dalam bidang media ni, kita perlu ada tanggungjawab. Bagi saya, kalau kita nak meningkatkan inovasi, kreativiti, satu sifat yang kena ada sifat berani. Sifat berani mencuba, sifat berani gagal pun kena ada. Sifat berani berambil risiko. Saya lihat 5 tahun kebelakangan ni, terutama baru-baru ni, dah banyak pihak kerajaan, pihak-pihak apa tu yang berkenaan sebenarnya dah lebih fokus kepada innovation ni. Tapi bagi saya, kita dah start. Itu benda yang bagus. Kerana biarlah inovasi ni bukan boleh change dalam satu malam saja. Maybe dia mengambil berapa lama, maybe bertahun, mungkin satu generasi, dua generasi dia bertukar. Kita sebenarnya, rakyat kita suka benda innovation ni. Kalau tidak, kita tengok dalam cerita buah-buah kenapa. Orang still berrelate dalam cerita buah-buah. Buah-buah ni kita mengambil konsep futuristik Malaysia. Dia lagi for the future. Orang suka. Maknanya rakyat kita, orang kita memang suka pada innovation. Maybe kita tidak diberi peluang lagi dengan secara menyeluruh. Lepas ni kalau kita ada peluang lagi banyak, saya rasa kita boleh menghasilkan banyak lagi tenaga pakar lah dalam bahagian kreatif, innovation dan juga hopefully innovation juga lah.